Right, Dan, excited?
I am.
Why not?
What do you mean no one's going to watch it? Yeah, okay, so this is going to be on YouTube and we're not doing it live. Yes, I know, but, well, tough. Well, you go and tell PGN to get us back on the air then. No, exactly. Huh? No, this is not some kind of ego trip. Cheeky bastard. Anyway, play my goddamn theme tune.
Championship Wrestling on PGN.
And it is a very, very warm welcome back to CCW Rectum. A word I thought I'd never be happy about saying again on the internet, but here we are. Welcome back. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening to you, wherever you may be in the world right now. This is the return of some semblance of CCW. Now, we've been away a long time. That's pretty obvious. It's been, what, a year now? Something like that. Anyway, here we are. We're back again in a, as you'll find out, in a different format. Now, clearly, you're not watching this live. This is a, obviously, pre-recorded show, unless this is some really weird technical wizardry, meaning that I'm managing to broadcast live over YouTube without actually being live on YouTube. That would be difficult. Technically not impossible, I suppose. Anyway, Dan, can we look into that? Thank you. Welcome back to the show. We have a shorter show than normal, but I thought we'd go a little bit shorter on this first one just to, well, see if anyone still gives a shit out there. That's the blunt truth about it. But it is a good show, nonetheless. We have a total of 5 matches coming up for you on tonight's show, and we are going in hard with the very first match on tonight's card being the defense of the Hall Ass Tag Team titles by the CWA. They will be facing tonight's challengers, the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Our second match is a very special one-on-one match with opponents chosen by CF Live and Mr. Landiggity. Now, I won't tell you who they are yet. You'll find out soon. Our third match is more tag team action as the Hammersons, our very own food truck owners, will take on Wayne's World. Fourth match is another one-on-one, or is it? You'll find out later. And we will end tonight's show with another title match, and it will see the return of the Cat Food Holiday Variety Show one-off match, which is now not a one-off match because it's happening again tonight. It is the defense of the World Christmas Championship, and it will see Santa the Bear defending his title against Santa. Yes, Santa wants his rematch. Okay, it's October, it's Halloween, just go with it, okay? There's stuff in the shops already, that's why we're doing it, right? Just don't question it. Anyway, let's get down to the ring for our first match, which will be the Hall Ass Tag Team titles. And here we go then for the very first match for CCW Rectum in a bloody long time. That is for the gold. There's one twist I kind of didn't tell you about on purpose because, you know, I forget shit. This is not just a standard tag team match. This is an elimination tag team match for the Hall Ass titles. Oh, yes, you heard me right. We have Woozle and Leo start this off. As you can see, Raphael in the corner for Leo with the other two turtles standing by just in case shit goes a bit pear-shaped on the outside of the ring, because that is highly likely with the way these matches go. Woozle in with the early pin. 1 minute in a 20-minute time limit, but no, kicks out at the one. Instantly goes in for the tag. Raphael coming in, trying to get some purchase here. But Leo's doing business now, apparently, because he can. Shell drop there from Raphael. Woozle tagged in Jericho. Double team, is an absolute failure. Therefore, the tag team actually is a failure, because as a team, they didn't actually tag in and work properly. Yeah, got out that one. Jericho blocking some kicks there. Nice hip toss as well. Slap across the shell. That's got to hurt his hand. Elbow again into the face, puts Raphael on the floor. Raphael, I think, looking for a tag somewhere. No, and blocked the kick again. Jericho is on fire with these kicks. Goes over, puts Raphael down, but kind of waits for him to get up. Not maybe the smartest territory. Oh, baseball slide to the head. That's going to leave a mark. Or three. Probably about size 10s of Jericho's boots. Puts Raph on the floor, drops the knee into the upper back as well. Swinging net breaker from Jericho, going up high. Lands the five-star splash, but no. Raph kicks out with a rope break. A lovely suplex there from Jericho. Tags in Woozle. Goes to the right, but just Woozle says, no, can't wait. I'm going to punch him anyway. And Jericho goes, why the hell did you do that? You just wasted my time. Thanks. This is a team that doesn't really get on, let's be honest about it. How they won the titles in the first place, I don't know. Probably Jericho. Yeah, that's probably what it is. Mr. I'll win three titles in one night, because apparently he can do that. I still can't believe that night happened, but anyway, it did. But the Turtles tonight have their chance for redemption, which means actually winning something that means anything in this promotion. Sorry, Spencer, but you know it's true. Backwards and forwards. The elbow, though, puts Jericho onto the floor. 5 minutes gone in this match of 20 minutes, time limit for the titles. If we do reach the 20-minute mark and there is no clear winner, the titles will remain with the CWA. So the Turtles have no option but to win this. Going with a submission, just laying the punches in, but in comes Woozle. Now with the submission move, but this won't count because he's not the legal man. 6 minutes gone now. Send for the ride. They just bumped chest. Jesus Christ, that's gotta hurt. How does that not hurt Jericho? I'm working the knee now. Lovely kick combo from Leo, using those feet to good effect. Brings in Raphael. Punches going in hard. And Jericho just basically running away. That's what he just did. He ran away from the Turtles, although two against one. No, I'll kind of give him that. These two go together. That's a lovely high kick from Raphael, pulling him back in, smelling a win here, I think. 7 minutes gone now in this match. But he goes for the... He went for the tag. He had Woozle on the ropes, almost literally, and he went for the... whatever. Pulled him back up. Just the straight midriff kick. And no, the small tackle there just buys Woozle some time. Both men get up at the same time. And Leo, I think, looking for the tag again, but no, going for the pin. It's a count. He's reached two. That could have been a three, I think, for not Jericho saving that match for them. Now Leo just lining up, just putting Jericho to the floor. He's doing some great work in a minute. The chest bump puts Woozle to the floor this time, sets him up. Oh, this is going to hurt. Oh, that's going to hurt. Yep, that's another mark left. 9 minutes gone now in this match with the 20-minute time limit for the Hall Ass Tag Team titles. I will keep reminding you of that because this is big. This is big. One half of that team holds three titles, including this one. Oh, the swing net breaker again, this time on Leo, and the dirty rake of the face with the boots. Sets him up. Oh, neck across the top rope. All the dirty moves coming out. This is a great combination from Jericho. Is Raphael too late? No, Leo kicks out at two. Thank God he kicked out at two. Not that I'm biased. Lovely combination round the head. He's just laying in the punches and kicks now. Wasting no time. Jericho dazed. But Leo wasting time by showing off the crowd. And now he's paying for it. Leg sweep puts him down. dragged back in the middle of the ring. Goes for the standing. Swanton again, and just... Oh, that was close. That was very close to a defence of the titles there. Pulls him back for the lariat. Jericho still going. He senses it. Walls! The walls! The walls are in! Raphael saves the day, though. Walls are coming in. Gives Raphael a boot to the midriff just for good measure. Lining up on Leo again, but continues to beat down on Leo. It's absolutely hammering us. And again, the walls! He's got to be weakened now. Surely he can't hold on. Raphael again saves the day. Just slaps now, a kick to finish it. Goes to Jericho, sends him back into the turtle's corner. Wise move, and he skips out the way of Leo. Jericho going straight across, sensibly for the tag. 12 minutes gone in this match now. Tag again. The crowd getting to a fever pitch. That's got to be a half power bomb, just saved from the full effect of that one. With Leo coming over to save, Raphael back to his feet, almost with it. Pulls him back up, but the elbow gets the separation. Where's he going? What's he doing with him now? Pulls him back into their corner. That's got to be an elbow into the middle of the back. Even with a shell, that hurts. Rolls him. Comes back up. Looks to carry the punishment. Oh! Oh! How did he just get up from that? What the hell? Is he wearing a helmet? Raph just took being pile driven into the back, on the back of his head into the mat, and he just got straight up like nothing happened. And now he's just punishing the hell out of Wolves. The pin! There's just a two count there, just for the titles almost, but Jericho comes in to save it. And now comes in with a massive scoop slam from Wolves on Leo. Doesn't need the roundhouse kick. The pin for the title, though, just a one count. Jericho aware to that one. Celebrates the crowd. Probably not the best timing. They both go for the run of the ropes, and Lariat puts him into the floor again. Wuzzle, nice little trip there. Gets the break, goes into the tag. Leo is in. Both of them are hunting down Wuzzle, and Wuzzle goes to tag. It's all broken down. All four men are now in the ring. It's all on the limit. Mental, the kicks. Three kicks landed perfectly by Leo. The momentum definitely switching now to the Turtles. 15 minutes gone. Time is not on the Turtles' side. They have to finish this one if they want the titles. This has got to be finished off in the ring. Super kick from a standing stop. We've got capitalized. Drop kick. Jericho drop kick. The walls. But surely. That's it. Leo's out. Raph is down on his own. Two. Surely. Ooh, is it going to be enough? Three. Jericho's out. It's 1-1 now. Wuzzle. Raph. This is the... Got to be in now. 16 minutes gone. It's a fight against time. Both men are absolutely battered. Super kick. 2 minutes. Surely. With a plum. With a beam. New champions. New Hall-Ass Tag Team Champions. The Turtles win the Hall-Ass Tag Team titles.
Now that was one hell of a way to open up CTW Rector. We have new Hall-Ass Tag Team titles, Leo and Raphael of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Congratulations, and thank God you took the title off CWA. Sorry, what? No, internal thoughts. Anyway, let's move on to our next match of the evening. Now, I said that this was, well, a bit of a special one-on-one match. So here's what's gone on. Before the show started, I asked CF and Diggity to each choose one combatant they couldn't choose themselves to go head-to-head in tonight's show in a one-on-one match. The choices were interesting. CF went for Ultimate J4, and Diggity went for Meggy Moo Moo. Now, there is another bit that I didn't tell them, and also you're also about to find out at the same time. The winner of this match will go on to take part in a 2-on-1 match later on, because you know I mentioned that surprise 1-on-1 match that's happening after the Hammersons versus Wayne's World? Well, yeah, the 1-on-1 match was the old rival CF Live versus Mr. Landiggity, and the winner gets to go in the corner of the person who chose them for this match. Yeah,
Didn't realise that one, did you, boys? So, let's get ringside and get this one on.
Fight!
So, here we go. A lot on the line then for this one-on-one match that they thought was going to be a simple one-on-one match. Now, I lied. We have, in the very fetching green boots and all-in-one yellow outfit, we have Meggie Moo Moo taking on the ultimate power of J4. 20-minute time limit for this match, which will be the same for all our matches on tonight's show. Now, the thing is, I wonder how much weight this is going to lean on this match for these two now. Knowing what it means, and also Meggie knowing that CF didn't think of her first. If that doesn't cause problems, nothing will. Lovely scoop slam from J4. As I've said many times, CCW is a equal opportunities employer, which means we give everyone equal opportunities to smash the shit out of each other. You know, why not? Lovely pullback lariat from J4. 2 minutes gone in this match so far. Meggie, though, double hammer on the upper back there. J4 just shaking that one off. Reverses, puts her into the corner. Oh, just going for that mash of the head into the corner. Wow. Okay, clearly J4 has no chivalry tonight. But then again, Meggie does give her own back, so, you know, actually, I wouldn't want to take a hit from Meggie. I mean, Jesus Christ. Oh, pile driver from Meggie, putting J4 on the floor. Flops on. Splash. Only a one count, though. 3 minutes gone in this match so far. You see, I wonder how much Meggie actually cares about the result here. Pin from the run. A two count. That was nearly a three count there. Misses with the lariat. Reversing. Pulls back without himself. J4 celebrating in the middle of the ring. Going for the run. Splash dive into the pin. Meggie just kicks out straight away. Absolutely no thought about staying there. Goes up into the chokehold. Is J4 going to give up? No. Flops him down. Meggie looking a little bit gassed already. It has been a long time since any of these people have actually fought in the ring. I mean, and like I said, it's been about a year. Another pile driver onto the top of the head of J4, looking a little bit lifeless there, but pulls him back up. Just clobbers. Clobbers him. Absolutely clobbers him. Holding back now. Going for the submission. Holding on that knee. 5 minutes gone in the match now. The kick just misses. And again, goes to the chokehold. This is going to have to cause some pain at the end, but a rope break is called by Jasper. I didn't think he'd actually do that. Jasper? Casper? Wow. Wrong name. That'll annoy him. Throw into the outside now. Meggie taking a chance to get some breath back. J4 straight back in, wasting no time whatsoever. And again, the elbow goes in. Knee in again to submission, pulling on that leg, working on the knee. Clearly wants to take the vertical base away from J4, but it's not quite working out. Again, the elbow. Repeated attacks in these areas, going for the pin. Gets a two and kicks out at the two. J4 missing with the lariat completely, but running shoulder breaker onto the knee, into the corner as well. Meggie fights her way out. Again, just clobbers him round the head. It has to be said that Meggie has got the upper hand here, but J4 keeps finding a way to fight back. Gets his face mashed into the floor there for his efforts. And the chokeslam into the pin at 7 minutes. Is it? Took it home. J4 is really, really on the ropes here. Going up. Pumps and the bear slam into the mat. Back of the head. J4 on the fight back now. Punches in. They steer it to the down. The punches go straight across between the two of them. He hulks up and just runs her through with a lariat. Drags to the middle, surely for a pin. No, he goes for more offense. Dives on for the pin. Knocks the out of the body. For a 3 and 2.9. Both of them now the 2.9. 8.5 minutes gone in this match. Another shoulder breaker. Now both absolutely looking spent. And Meggie just not with it yet. He's taking the advantage, but missing with a shoulder charge. She sees it coming and steps out of the way. Puts him in the corner. And oh, for the second time tonight. We see the top rope used. No rope break. I thought his view was under. 2.9 again. 9 minutes gone now. This is going backwards and forwards here. Trading 2.9 pins. Goes in. Slams down again. Drives the air of the chest. And a
force two foot around the ring. This is just ridiculous behaviour. These two just do not want to give up. Maybe it does mean something to Matt for. Drops the elbow at the back of the head. That's got to cause some pain around the neck area there. 10 minutes gone now. Halfway through this match. Holds her up and just slams down onto the mat. J4 looking like he means business. Has he swung his match back? The two fast elbows there from Maggie put paid to that offense. She's back. She's dancing. Why is she dancing? Why is she dancing? It's not a disco. Clearly felt she had the time, but no, J4 spends time, holds her up, the blood rushing to the head of Maggie, and puts her down hard, but now he can't get back up into the pin, and Maggie's up at the same time. This is with the elbow, again, repeating the same process, looking to get her completely dizzy with all that blood just rushing down her body. Back up. Again, can't capitalize. Maggie not with it. J4 needs a breath. Just one simple punch puts her to the floor. Elbow again to break it. Lariat, hard lariat across the throat there. Putting J4 to the floor. The punches, the quick punches. Both. No, there is. The end is very close. They get the front. Running Bourbon. Surely. Two. Oh. 2.9. How the hell did he kick out of that? Running Bourbon for Maggie. Has finished many a match in the past. They fight on. 12 minutes gone in this match. And now they continue to batter each other backwards and forwards. There seems to be no end to this one at all. 7 minutes to go before the end of time. That shoulder charge missing. They are just absolutely showing their tiredness of them. Back, missing their hits. Left, right and centre here. J4 looking to get some advantage here. Lariat puts it to the floor. Maggie tries to get out of the way. Gets her up. Oh! The fence post driver drops the elbow. Surely. But he's back up. How the hell is he up after that? And just puts her down with an elbow. He's just taken a fence post driver and an elbow, and he gets up and gets back on the offense again. J4 is something else tonight. The elbow again across the back of the head. Almost 15 minutes done in this match. Oh, she reverses it. Surely. The win. Okay, two count. He kicks out yet again, just the two count. J4 back on the offense now. Driving the foot in. Goes for the run. Dive onto the lower back. Driving the wind again out of Maggie Sales. And back up once more. The fourth time now he's done this. But it seems to be working. It has given him the edge. On the first two, 15 minutes done, only 4.5 minutes gone, left now, in this match. That must have a conclusion. He goes to the shoulder charge, manages to land it this time, but makes it straight back up again. Spins it around with a pole driver. Can she capitalize? Can she get the pin? She can't. J4 is back up again. The strength and fortitude these two have is absolutely ridiculous. Maggie just taking the moment to get some air back in those lungs. J4 doing the same, diving shoulder charge there, put Maggie back on the floor. Bear hug, that is all over. Ultimate J4 has won with the bear hug. That puts him into the 2-on-1 fight later on in the show.
Remember when food used to be wholesome and delicious? Cat Foods Farm remembers. Crafted responsibly, deep in the heart of Manitoba, with care and love. Free range, all natural, only the very best of ingredients. Simply delicious.
May or may not be fit for human consumption. Eating may cause cancer, kidney disease, diabetes, lethargy, and existential crisis.
Cat food.
And welcome back from that ad break to CCW Rectum. I hope you enjoyed the show so far, but what a blockbuster match that was. So, we now know that the 2-on-1 match later on this evening will be... this is going to have repercussions. This will be CF Live with Ultimate J4 in a tag team against, on his lonesome, Mr. land diggity. Let me just tell you, in that ad break, I caught an eyeball of Meggy coming backstage and, yeah, she's pissed. CF, if you can currently hear this, run. Just run. Anyway, before we get to that, we have another tag team bout to get our teeth into. That will be the Hammersons versus Wayne's World. Let's get you down to the ring. So here we go again, tag team action with the Hammersons versus Wayne's World. Starting off, as you can see, we have Garth and Greg. Val, of course, is the other half of the Hammersons. If you don't know who the Hammersons are, they are the people that run the food truck. That kind of isn't outside of CCW right now because, well, yeah, they lost their license and permit to trade in a van. So yeah, the food truck has kind of disappeared a little bit. They've still got it, but we're working out some, let's call it legalities about them serving food, not because of hygiene reasons at all, or out-of-date products at all. That's, no, never. Anyway, back to the match. So, as a tag team action here, amazingly non-title, there's nothing on this match at all. It feels a little bit weird. But anyway, there's plenty on this match because, well, I put it out to the locker room that I won another tag team match and they came forward. And here we go, we've got a tag team match, simple as that. So, Wayne coming in. Wayne, the definite powerhouse of Wayne's World, which I know if you know Wayne's World sounds weird, but he definitely is. But Val now kicking some butt. Oh, ducks the lariat. Nicely ducked there. Goes in for the tackle. Goes to the mount, but just misses out the mount. Lovely kick out there by Val. Putting Wayne back to the floor. These two just training blows right now. Lovely, lovely hit on the back. Oh, and going for the submission already. Greg just stands there? Wow. That either shows faith in their relationship or he can't be bothered. If it's the latter, he's stuck. The tag. Garth comes in. Tag team. And they do the sweep on Larry down the floor. Val is in trouble here. As Garth takes the reins. Picking his spot. Pacing round. Scoop slam started off with. Goes on the attack, and Val finds her escape route. Brings in Greg, but still gets her head pounded into the ring post for good measure. Now Garth in trouble here a little bit, and just driving it with the shoulder. Greg getting his own back, he's had enough. He wants some more, the elbows. Swinging backwards and forwards. And the winner just about there is Greg, who collapses with the effort. Really? Is he that tired? Has he not done anything at all? Although he's been trying to run the food truck and that's kind of run to the ground. So, yeah, he's pretty bit knackered. Oh, goes for the dick shot. But just runs away from Garth and lets him get the tag. Now double team. Again, this time, Greg gets the treatment. Poor bugger. 20-minute time limit. We are 5 minutes now, 5.5 minutes, in fact, into this match. Swing and a miss from both of them there. Val now taking up the attack. Nice double drop kick from the Hammersons there. Wayne misses, but gets the DDT in the middle of the ring, across the throat with the elbow. Chasing his prey. This still feels like we're in the... Oh, that's a nasty one on the knee. It still feels like these two teams are still vying for control at this early point in the match. Suplex takes Val down onto the floor. And he drags her back to where he needs it. Totally and utterly missed the cut. What was he doing there? Oh, pushes Calf to the floor. He just missed out on that one. So smart offense here. And this is really what we're seeing here. Both teams are really very quite skilled. They know how to avoid things, but they know how to attack hard. But that's a lovely backdrop. Puts Wayne to the outside. They both just come in for the center, wait their time, get their breath back. Greg absolutely swing and a miss there, which gives Wayne the opportunity to get Garth into the match. The two of them now work over Greg. And Greg doing the same thing. No, Greg just goes, stop this, I'm going to attack you. Oh, into the submission. That's a lovely move from Garth there. Pulls him in. Greg, though, in no mood to give up yet. Those arms, they're going to be hard to break on a submission, let's be honest. Now, Garth going back to the basic attacks here. 8.5 minutes going into the match. Another DDT there, this time on Greg from Garth. Stomping a mud hole into the stomach. Lovely high kick out of nowhere. Running in and goes to the tag. Are they both going to go after him? I think they are. Trying to outpace him and just get him into the corner and work him over a little bit. Separate Wayne's World, but Garth just fighting his way out of that like it was nothing. Oh, little kick. Little kick. But he manages to break away and Wayne comes back in. Real back and forth there. 9.5 minutes gone in this match so far. This one could go the full distance of 20 minutes before we head into our handicap match next on tonight's show. Drops the elbow across the head. Foul. Looking to chase, but no, and in for the submission. Surely a rope break there. The referee does indeed call the rope break. Bell's feet just underneath the ropes. Wayne cursing his luck there for his placement. And Lovely sells it on him with the one foot. High kick with the other, driving the knee now. In and working all parts of the body, not really targeting one area, which is unusual for Val and Greg there. Usually quite bang on and managed to get those moves in to target the areas, weaken their opponent as much as they can. Lovely sweep there, whilst Greg distracts him. But indeed, he's hit again from Wayne. Slowly this time. He's slowing down a little bit now. I think it's time to take his toll. He's hit 11 minutes gone in this match. The headbutt, just glancing blow, I think, there on Garth. They bump in the middle. Central right shoulder charge this time, puts Garth on the floor, knee across the forehead. Is it just me, or does Garth look more like Spike Dudley every day? I don't know. Just an observation. Maybe he is Spike Dudley. No, can't be. Pin! Oh, cheeky pin there from Garth. There, puts him down, elbow across the throat once more. Coming in, pulls him down. Oh, that's a painful submission, but the rope break is called. Has to give it up. Both teams playing it very clean here tonight, though, as we said. And now all four combatants in the ring at once. Val and Wayne. Wayne the upper hand, Greg the upper hand. Greg just runs away. Doesn't just looks at Garth, says, "You carry on, Wayne, please carry on, I don't mind." Nice hip toss there from Val. Knows to be left a little on her own, but oh, head takedown and the kick from the floor by Val. A figure four, he's in. There's no rope break this time. Is that it? Rex is standing there, but she kicks out. Don't think he quite had the full purchase of that one. 14 minutes now gone in this match. There's Wayne running in. Oh, the jawbreaker. Val's like, well, what you gonna do? Oh, the 360 from the top rope into the pin, but the rope break was called. Unless the chair trick comes back again. Wayne selling the chair trick. Val is like, this is not real. It's not happening. I didn't do it, ref. Wasn't me. The ref not falling for it at all. Break comes in. Oh, wow! With a pin, surely. Just a two count. Lovely move out of nowhere, and Wayne cleaning house, breaking up Anderson there, doing the sensible thing. As Val comes back in, sends the right. Greg just says, no you don't, son. Puts him down the floor. Possible double team coming up here as we hit the 16-minute mark. Both teams will be desperate now to get the win in this hard-fought match here. Lovely heel around the back of the head on Val. Greg catches him up, knees him into the stomach, takes the window away from him, sets him up. Oh, that's going to stink tomorrow. He might not be shitting for a week after that one. Attack. Comes in. Double team. Greg fights his way straight out of it. Misses with a lariat on Garth, though. Garth was on back. He can't do it. Reversal. Suplex to the outside. Garth is looking very out of it. No, he's back up on his feet. I thought he was knocked out there. Greg was going for a spinneroony. Didn't have time. Garth in. Oh, that flying knee. Enziguri style knee across the head there. Greg is back up there. Oh, oh my god! Oh. Brainbuster! In! For the win! Surely! For the win! Wayne breaks it up. Two count only. 17 minutes. 18 minutes now going in this match. Looking out with the run there from Val. This match just stepped up a pace. Greg is out. Is that the submission? The submission! No! Couldn't quite get it to pull out. And with those legs, though, that's hard to do. They've not really worked the legs to break very much this match. There wasn't really the space to do that. But, oh, backbreaker from Val. Running knee from Wayne.
It's all kicking off now. Greg gets out. Told to leave. Garth leaves as well. Wayne, Larry, 19 minutes gone now.
Kick it forward in the corner. Can Greg get there? Can Greg get there?
He does, he gets there. Breaks it up. Double team on Val. Greg can do nothing about it for some reason. Just stands there. Goes in. And now they trade backwards and forwards. Drop kick. Puts him down. Pulls him into the centre. We've hit 20 minutes. Someone just tell Casper just to carry on. This can just keep going. This is too good. Don't stop this now. 20 minutes has elapsed. I don't care. Just keep this going. My company can do what I damn well want.
Oh, the double team. Oh, go off. The leg drop from the top. Surely. The pin. For the match.
Great.
The Hammersons win in just over 20 minutes. What an epic match. Congratulations, Mal and Greg. And if that is not contender for match of the evening, I am stunned. Awesome win there for the Hammersons. Congratulations once again to Greg and Val. Holy hell, I don't care if we're over 20 minutes. Like I said, I'm the boss. I can do what I want. I don't care. I mean, I'm going to get complaints from Wayne's World now I've done that, but whatever. They know where the door is. Anyway, let's move on to our next match of the evening. This is the special one-on-one match that I kind of didn't tell you about properly, but following the result of the early match between Ultimate J4 and Megi Mumu, with J4 taking the victory, that means that we now have a two-on-one tag team match, which will see CF Live teaming up with J4 to take on his lonesome, Mr. Landiggity. I'm really quite pleased with myself. I never told them why they were picking somebody. Sometimes I forget I'm a genius. Anyway, let's get down to the ring.
Fight.
And we are underway then in this tag team kind of bout, which isn't really tag team. Well, at least not particularly. Sorry. Again, that's internal thoughts. Must have internal thoughts. We start off then with CF from the tag team of CF and J4 going at this match. Megan you will spot just in the corner. She is allowed ringside, but is not allowed to interject in the match. Otherwise, it's an instant disqualification for Mr. Landiggity. Will she care, though? I don't know. She probably won't give a damn. I mean, she's probably just pissed off at CF. I mean, wouldn't you be? Anyway, let's get onto the match and, you know, commentate on it. So, 20-minute time limit once again, as with all the matches tonight. I may break it depending on how long it goes or how good it is. Lovely, lovely move there from CF. Dropping the big foot across the neck. Now going for the tag for the first time in this match, but the second time this evening, J4 taking up action in the ring now, going up against Mr. Landiggity this time. Whether this is a different proposition and a nonchalant pin there with a two minutes gone. I mean, that's just cheeky. Bearing in mind, J4 did go through a very hard match against Meggy, stood ringside at the moment, and he still got the balls to do that as he stamps on Diggity's balls. Well, you know, prophetic, maybe. Going in with a submission. CF just stands there. No, J4's got it. Diggity launching some offense here, trying to get some momentum going. What he desperately needs to do is go for the submission again. Pulls back on that neck really hard. But the break for the submission, a little bit too early. He needs to separate one of these two out to have any chance of winning this match in any way, shape, or form. But now going after the wrong man. I don't think he realizes that CF is the legal man. And indeed, he does eventually work it out. Goes in with a nicely upper-level suplex. Sends him for the ride. Nice elbow. Going across the nose, puts him down. Figure four. There's a ring. Could it be? No. With those feet, not going to happen. I don't know how he can got the figure four in with those feet. Anyway. Running elbow. CF straight back up, though. Holds him up, and the elbow's going in again. Diggity showing off his MMA skills here. And now they trade the midriff kick. The European uppercut with those massive forearms. That's just... it's just offensive. The elbow dropped to the back of the head. 5 minutes gone on this match now. 20-minute time limit. Diggity already gassed. He's supposed to be the freshest one here. But
the pace of this match going 2-1 is really starting to show. You have to say, honestly, if he does come out with a win here, this will be a standing with a pin.
Two.
And only just under 6 minutes gone in the match. It was almost all over right there and then. Jake Paul sensing blood going now for the jugular, trying to completely wear Diggity down, back of the head with the elbow. Straight across the back of the head there. Diggity goes for the tag, remembers that he can't, remembers that although Meggy is there, he can't tag her in. Reversal, J4 keeping the pressure hard here. I'm sorry, Diggity's got no chance. I'm going to call it out. He has got no chance whatsoever. The pin. Is he going to be over 7 minutes? Nope, 2.9, he fights on. But he is keeping J4 in the ring. No, he's not. J4 soon separated, brings in the fresher man, CF coming all the way over. They double team in the corner. The diving elbow. Randy Savage is in the building, ladies and gentlemen. Drops it again for the second time. Lower back. Driving the air out of the lungs. Working the core. Stopping the movement and fluidity of balance for Diggity. But he's up and at it again. Fights away out of that double team. Goes up top. That could be a bad idea. But he drops an elbow of his own on CF's stomach. Not realizing, I think, that J4 is the legal man and just misses with the elbow. J4 ducks out the way. We have hit 8 minutes. Oh, swinging lariat to the back of the head. Puts him down face first. Diggity not quite with it. That kick just a thin air. And down again. And the inevitability of this match has just become very, very clear, I think, to you and me. Do you know what? Here's the thing. Diggity wins this, I'll give him a pay rise. As he gets thrown to the outside. Yeah, okay. Dan, did he hear that? This isn't being pumped down the ring, is it? No? Okay, that's good. I don't care if it's been recorded. I'll just wipe it later. I'll edit. It's fine. It's an edit. My producer worrying about legalities of saying things on camera. Right. Back to the match. 10 minutes gone now. J4 starting to work once more on Diggity, who is absolutely done this, but how he's still fighting. Do you know what? Actually, I have a lot of respect for Diggity here. He's gone 10 minutes, 2-on-1 situation. Oh, he just folds him in half. With the pin, the two hands, and it's all over. It is all over. The 2-1 becomes too much. The team of CF and J4 take the victory. Something tells me the repercussions of that match will be felt way beyond tonight. But indeed, it is a victory for the team of J4 and CF Live. Have we seen the birth of a brand new tag team here in CCW? Probably not. Let's be honest, it's not going to happen. I mean, honestly, do you know how long it took me to get CF actually wrestling tonight? It makes an art format that can't be asked. Hang on, I'm hearing Dan. Is that Meggy? I can hear her out. Okay, we've got a developing situation here. To say that Meggy is slightly annoyed is kind of putting... She's pissed. She's very pissed off. Okay. Can you go and monitor that? Because that doesn't... Okay, between you and me, Dan, we could have a match for the next show brewing out there now. Okay, just go. Yeah, go sort it. Okay, thank you. Right. Gone from a wrestling match to a domestic, I think, outside. But anyway, let's move on with the show. So, we began tonight with tag team gold, changing hands with the Turtles, finally getting some straps around their waist. And we are going to end this show with yet more gold, potentially changing hands. If you saw the Cat Food Holiday Variety Show 2021 early this year, well, end of last year, it's all blurred into one right now, then you would have seen the very special one-off show which saw Santa Claus, yes, that Santa Claus, take on Santa the Bear. I still don't know who put the Santa hat and the trunks on him because it's such a disturbing... Anyway... Santa the Bear, for the newly christened, for that event only, for the World Christmas Championship. Now, that was meant to be a one-off, never repeated before, after, again, because it's too stupid to do again, championship. However, this is CCW. We do stupid shit all the time. And that's exactly what's going to happen for the second time. We are giving Santa Claus the chance to redeem himself and take back the title that, quite frankly, should have won in the first place, because, goddammit, it's Santa the Bear. It's a bear in a Santa hat. He lost to a bear in a... Anyway, this is our final match of the show. We hope you have enjoyed this show. Let's take you down to the ring for the possible exchange of championship gold. This is it. Here we go. We are off. This is the final match of this show. It is for the World Christmas Championship. Defending his title is Santa the Bear in the sexiest trunks you've ever seen in your life on a bear against the one and only Santa Claus. Santa needs redemption tonight. It's as simple as that. So early going here in this match, which is set for a 30-minute time limit for this particular championship, with the bear going for the claws in the eyes already, trying to blind Santa. Damn, it's October, son. Give him a chance. Elbow across the jaw. It's either going to go the full 30, it's going to be over really quickly. I don't quite know how it's going to go yet. I feel it's going to be a full 30 and a non-contest, but we might have to run it again. I don't know. We'll see. Anyway, Santa. Santa Beth, just a straight strike to the jaw. Casper just ignoring it completely. I got his name right this time. The pin, early pin, 2 minutes in, just the one count, though. The bear kicks out immediately, wanting none of that, defending his championship to the best of his abilities. Goes for the shoulder charge, but completely misses. How he got... I don't know. Rake of the eyes again, sends him over. And just, is he trying to rip his mince pies out of his stomach? I think, and going for the eyes to break it up. He does manage to break it up, though. Reversal. Oh, my God! He just landed Santa on the top of his head on the apron. And he gets back in 3 minutes gone. Oh, my God, this is serious. Oh, Jesus Christ. I think the bear might want to keep this title. I've got to have words with dignity. I never thought letting this bear in CCW would actually get this far. Santa with that no, you don't, son. Getting his own back with the elbow across the face, uppercut, but the bear just eats the uppercut and comes straight back, ties him up. All this looks dangerous. Oh, he's going for the knees. Scratches those knees. Takes out the patellas as much as he can. Both go for lariat. Both miss completely. I don't know how, but oh. Palm strikes into the face. DDT slows down Santa the Bear, but he's back up first. Santa is looking distinctly knackered at this point, which means he should be training for Christmas, but double lariat there. But the bear, having none of it, kicks straight to the face to break that up. 5 minutes gone, and just lamping him with the punches. The referee doing a very slow 10 count here, letting it happen. Santa gets his way out of it. 5.5 minutes. Oh, my God, yes, the bear is absolutely on fire tonight. Oh, gutter. Gutter for the reversal. Can he capitalize now? He has to capitalize. Surely this has to do something here. Bear hug. Could it be it again? Could it be over? There's no way of saving. No, he manages to break out. Oh my God, powerbomb. I'm just on top again, absolutely laying the shots into Santa's face. He covers up as best he can and gets away. And for a two count, the referee goes in with the butt strike. That's a thing? It took him out, so it worked. Takes the win over. And again, the palm strikes to the face and the lariat to finish it off. Puts him into the floor. 7 minutes gone in this match now. Stomping holes into his stomach. Whatever. Words are hard. And goes in with a pin. In the face. What the hell is Max doing here? But that's it. It's all over. Santa the Bear retains the World Christmas Championship. That is how you defend a title. That is how you legitimize a title. And that is how you stay the World Christmas champion. Here was me thinking, that's it. Santa's going to win it back. We'll bury the title. It's done. I can't go any further with this one. Now, who the hell is going to take on Santa the Bear and beat Santa the Bear for the World Christmas Championship? I open the doors to the whole locker room. If anybody wants to challenge the Bear, I don't care if it's Christmas or not. If you want to challenge the Bear for that, here is an open offer to the whole locker room. Whenever we are putting a show together, you can put your hat in the ring, quite literally if you have one, and put yourself in as number one contender for a match in that show against Santa the Bear for that title. Bring some plasters and bandages. You're going to need them afterwards. Anyway, that is our show. We hope you have enjoyed it. From myself, from my producer, Dan, thank you for watching this. Thank you for putting up with the very low quality wrestling that's on offer. Or is that just a production? It's probably just a production. Until we meet again, whenever that may be, keep it rectum. I wish you peace, love, and cheese biscuits. And good night.
Right. Press stop.